There is a beautiful lake located in southern Siberia, Russia. Its name is Lake Baikal, and it is the largest freshwater lake by volume in the world. Actually, it contains 23% of the world's fresh surface water. That's more water than all of the North American Great Lakes combined. With a maximum depth of 1,642 meters, 5,387 feet, Baikal is also the world's deepest lake. It is among the world's clearest lakes, and it is the world's oldest lake at 25 to 30 million years. Russian astronomers decided to build a giant telescope and put it in Lake Baikal. I know what you're thinking. What? Well, actually, it's a space telescope. It's just a very special one. Join us as we get to know more about the giant telescope Baikal, GVD, that has been launched underwater to peer deep into the universe. I know it sounds weird, a space telescope underneath the surface of a lake. I see your point. Every time we think about a space telescope, the first thing that comes to mind is something like the Hubble Space Telescope that amazed us with this sort of image. Or maybe we recall the famous Spitzer Space Telescope, or Chandra that gave us infrared images or X-ray images. But this is different. Russian scientists launched one of the world's biggest underwater space telescopes to peer deep into the universe from the pristine waters of Lake Baikal. At this point, we ask ourselves, what type of experiments can we conduct underwater? How is it possible to conduct astrophysics studies with a telescope in a lake? Well, have you ever heard of neutrinos? In the study of physics, one has to deal with matter and its components, the elementary particles. Elementary particles are the simplest components of matter. But they are not part of the atoms that make up matter. They are outside. They are indivisible, i.e. they are not composed of even simpler particles, and are devoid of electric charge. Therefore, they are neutral. And most importantly, they have an extremely small mass. A neutrino is an elementary particle that interacts only via the weak interaction and gravity. The neutrino is so named because it is electrically neutral, and because its rest mass is so small that it was long thought to be zero. The rest mass of the neutrino is much smaller than that of the other known elementary particles, including massless particles. Small neutrinos are the most abundant particles in the universe, but despite this, they very rarely interact with matter. Just think, they can go through enormous thicknesses undisturbed, and even an entire planet, the Earth for example, and perhaps even travel the universe for eternity without being blocked by anything. Continuing on, here are 10 quick facts about neutrinos. Number 1. Trillions of harmless particles stream through you every second, night or day. Number 2. They are the second most abundant particle in the universe, after particles of light called photons. Number 3. Neutrinos rarely interact with anything. A light year of lead would only stop about half of the neutrinos coming from the sun. Number 4. About 15 billion neutrinos from the Big Bang are in the average room. Number 5. Neutrinos interact only through two of the four known forces, the weak force and gravity. Number 6. So far, scientists have discovered three types of neutrinos: electron neutrino, muon neutrino, and tau neutrino. Number 7. They oscillate or change direction as they travel. Number 8. Their masses are very tiny, but not yet known. Number 9. Their speed is very close to the speed of light, but also not known exactly. Number 10. They could be the reason that matter exists in the universe. But here comes the problem. How can we detect neutrinos? Neutrinos are passing through your body in vast numbers all the time. They are flooding out of the sun from its central furnace. And even if it is nighttime where you are, those neutrinos are passing right through the Earth and through your body as though the Earth wasn't even there. Cosmic rays, high-energy particles flying in from deep space, often strike atoms in the high atmosphere and produce a number of neutrinos. These too go right through you, almost always. But a tiny, tiny fraction of these neutrinos do actually hit something. And that's just what we need. In fact, sometimes neutrinos enter the nucleus of an atom, pass into one of the protons and neutrons, and roughly speaking, come very close to a quark in the proton or neutron. Then there is a moderate chance that the neutrino will quark and strike each other. If the neutrino has enough energy, it will blow the nucleus apart into its protons and neutrons, and often if the neutrino's energy is quite high, also make some other types of particles. Then the neutrino will continue on, undetected of course, but its trace, represented by the recoiling particles, can be observed as they too run into other atomic nuclei, smashing them apart in turn. Precisely how observation is done depends on the individual detector. There are many other neutrino detectors around the world, using different materials and different strategies. A common technique is to build a huge detector full of water or some other clear liquid, stick it far underground away from ordinary cosmic ray debris, and wait patiently for the occasional neutrino from the sun, or one from a cosmic ray, or a few from a supernova to make a splash. So now that we explained what a neutrino is and how it can be detected, we can understand the strong motivations that led Russian astronomers and physicians to place a space telescope under Lake Baikal. This huge neutrino detector was dubbed Baikal-GVD, and we can read on the Russian website, "The Baikal Deep Underwater Neutrino Telescope, or Baikal-GVD, Gigaton Volume Detector, is an international project in the field of astroparticle physics and neutrino astronomy. The construction of Baikal-GVD is motivated by its discovery potential in astrophysics, cosmology, and particle physics. Its primary goal is the detailed study of the flux of high-energy cosmic neutrinos and the search for their sources. Baikal-GVD will also search for dark matter candidates for neutrinos from the decay of superheavy particles, for magnetic monopoles and other exotic particles. It will also be a platform for environmental studies in Lake Baikal." Russian scientists say the telescope is the largest neutrino detector in the Northern Hemisphere, and Lake Baikal, the largest freshwater lake in the world, is ideal for housing the floating observatory. Of course, Lake Baikal is the only lake where you can deploy a neutrino telescope because of its depth. Bershoy Bonov of the Joint Institute for Nuclear Research told AFP, "Fresh water is also important, water clarity too, and the fact that there is ice cover for 2.5 months is also very important. Before we get to the end of the video, we want to get a better understanding of why neutrinos are so important to physics. Neutrinos are thought to be by far the most abundant particles in the entire universe. About 100 trillion neutrinos pass through your body every second, even if you don't seem to be aware of that. They pass through the atmosphere, through your roof, and finally go through your body without interacting with any of the particles they meet in the roof or in your body. You never notice them. We could compare a neutrino to a ghost. The combination of that ghostly presence and the important role neutrinos play in the universe captivates physicists. Neutrinos play a role in many fundamental aspects of our lives. They are produced in nuclear fusion processes that power the sun and other stars. They are produced in radioactive decays that provide a source of heat inside our planet. And they are produced in nuclear reactors. Neutrinos are also believed to be a vital ingredient in a star's supernova process. These are huge explosions that spread heavy elements throughout space, elements that are needed to create the universe we live in. Indeed, the sentence, "we are made of stars," is pretty much true. Neutrinos also provide a tool to study the structure of nucleons, protons, and neutrinos, to learn how matter evolved from simple particles into more complex composites of particles, creating literally everything around us. Before physicists can answer these questions and understand better the role neutrinos play in the evolution of our universe, they need to better understand how neutrinos interact with other particles. Experiments such as MINERVA are being conducted to precisely characterize different types of neutrino interactions and to study the physical processes that govern these interactions. MINERVA's data will be of great use to neutrino experiments such as MINOS, NOVA, and LBNE that study how neutrinos oscillate or change types. By offering a more detailed explanation of how neutrinos interact in a detector, these experiments can measure the details of neutrino oscillations with high precision. Through the combination of data from low-energy and high-energy neutrino experiments, physicists can get a more complete picture of how neutrinos behave and their role in our universe. Some other important studies on neutrinos are being conducted by the Ice Cube Neutrino Observatory in Antarctica. It was the first detector of this kind, designed to observe the cosmos from deep within the South Pole ice. If there's one thing that physics teaches us, is never taking anything for granted. Even the most minuscule and apparently meaningless particle in the cosmos could give us the knowledge we need to understand the deepest secrets of the universe we live in. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Are you in love with neutrinos? What do you think is more spectacular? A space telescope in space or a space telescope underneath the surface of Lake Baikal? Is there anything more you want to hear? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.